everyone. Welcome to a Yin Yoga session with myself, Debbie. I hope you're all keeping well, keeping safe. And I would like you to find a nice comfortable place on the floor. With your legs crossed, remember to have your props handy, which would be a cushion, a blanket, or if you're lucky enough to have a bolster, just have it close by and maybe some water. So what we're going to do before we go into our first pose this afternoon tonight is ground first, and then our first pose we're going to do is butterfly. We're going to go straight into the hips today and really specialise in getting these hips opened, because this is where we carry a lot of our emotional tension, is our hips. And when we're sitting down a lot, which we're probably maybe doing a wee bit more of, maybe sitting in the sitting sunbathing or watching the television or sitting on our computers, we're compressing all the time. So we're making these hips tighter all the time. So what we're going to do tonight is open the hips. We're going to do a lot of hip opening and just sort of really work on opening the hips. So we just start off just sitting in our easy cross-legged position, if that's comfortable for you. If you have got really tight hips, you could sit in a cushion. You could sit on a bolster if you have one. So basically you're raising the hips off the mat. Okay. So you just want to sit up nice and tall for a few moments and maybe roll from side to side, which is a lovely way of just grounding down into your sit bones. And you can actually put your hand on your leg and you sort of twist the thigh around a wee bit too. And that just gives you a wee bit more stability. And then we're just going to sit up nice and tall for a few more. So we want to lengthen through the spine. So if you remember, your spine is your main energy channel where energy flows. And a lot of us probably are feeling maybe a wee bit stressed at the moment. Maybe a wee bit confused by the news, because we're hearing different things. Maybe there's a bit of anxiety there, a bit of fear. And when we're feeling like this, our body, I always talk about that wee traffic jam goes into this wee traffic jam. So we want to release out of the traffic jam. Because when we're in the traffic jam, sure, energy's not moving the way it should move. It's sort of more tighter. And you're going to feel more tighter and your energy's not going to be great. So we want to come out of that. And how we're going to come out of that is by going into a nice breathing practice. So if you just sit up nice and tall first, make sure you're comfortable, because you're going to be here for about 2 or 3 minutes. So you want to make sure you're comfortable in this position. And we want to become silent. We want to silence the mind. And how we help to silence the mind is to start concentrate on the breath. So if you're happy enough and comfortable enough to sit with your eyes closed, maybe playing some nice gentle music in the background of your own, or using mine. And just start letting your body relax. Start noticing what parts of your body are you holding tension on. Just with your eyes closed, just be an observer. Just sit and observe your body. Where are you feeling any tension? How do your shoulders feel right now? Soften your face. Soften your face and just let the body relax. Soften your mouth, which has helped to soften your jawline. And start really connecting in with the breath. And as you breathe in, I want you to breathe in. I want you to lengthen up through your spine on the in-breath. And then I would love you to ground on the out breath. So I want you to breathe in for a count of 8. Breathe in. Pause for 4. And release for 8. And I would love you to do this breath through your nostrils if you could. So breathe in for 8. Pause for 4. And then release out for 8. We're going to do that 3 more times. And when you do that little pause at the top, think about plugging your phone in. So when you breathe in, think about breathing in fresh, new, beautiful, positive energy into the body. Pause at the top, plug your phone in, recharge the body, recharge your batteries. And on that out breath, just let go of tension from them shoulders, from the face, from the back, from the neck. Just let go of tiredness, let go of fear. And next time you breathe in for 8 again, I want you to breathe that beautiful, new, fresh, positive prana into the body. Life. Breath life into your body. Open it up like a flower. Pause at the top and then slowly release it out. Let go. Let go. And then just go back to your normal breath. When our breath is quiet, our mind is quiet. When our breath is quiet and our mind is quiet, we're using less energy, so our energy is within. Think about 70,000 thoughts a day that we have no control over. You're the observer of your thoughts. You don't need to connect in with them. You're just the observer of them. They will come and go like emotions. So if your eyes were closed, let's just gently open the eyes and just give them circles, a lovely roll. Think of all that fresh, new prana energy that you've brought into the body. Put your hands to the side, fingers down, turn the palms up, and breathe that energy right up over the head. Pause at the top. Oh, and breathe out. Let's do that again. Big deep breath in. Let's take the hands right above the head. But let's keep the right hand there, take the left hand down and just gently ease over to the side, keeping the right glute firmly on the mat. Your bicep would be coming across your ear, the arm on the floor would be coming forward slightly and the arm at the top would be going back slightly. And just breathe into the space that you're creating from the armpit to the floor. Think of opening the body so the prana can flow. And then we're slowly coming back up, pausing, and going to the other side, just slow and controlled. Think the lovely flow of movement now in the body as we gently reach over the other side, closing the eyes if you want again so you can feel that energy flow down the other side. And then slowly come back up. We want to take the body as slow as we can. We're going to put the hands behind the back and we're just going to lift the chest to the ceiling, Rotate them shoulders right back. And breathe into the chest, into the lungs, into the heart. And then slowly we're going to walk forward. So just walk across the body, just as if you're walking with your hands across your body. And you're just going to come forward nice and slow and just slide those fingers forward. And maybe just rock from side to side. And then drop the chest a little further, whatever feels right for you. Listen to your body. Remember, you would just be feeling for a lovely stretch now in the hips, the shoulders, drop the chin to the chest. Settle into the pose, relax. Take the right hand towards the right knee, put the left hand on top of that without lifting that beautiful glute off the mat, keep the glute down. You may feel this into the knee. From here, lift that arm up and stretch open. Lovely big stretch open, big deep breath in, and slowly release down again, just working through the shoulders. And then slowly walking across to the other side, gently putting the left hand down, put the right hand on top here, and keep the right glute to the mat. Relax the back, neck, and shoulders again. Take the right arm up, beautiful stretch. And slowly come back down again. Pause and feel. And then slowly come forward one more time. Gently reaching forward, lengthen through the spine. Coming back up. And let's come into our beautiful first pose, our butterfly pose. Just take the legs out a wee bit, just give them a wee shake. Now just roll the feet, just give your ankles a wee rotation. And then just gently bring the feet together. We're just going to keep the feet together, so there is a lovely gap between the heels and the ground. And this is where your props come in. So if you had a bolster, you could have it here, which is a beautiful place to put it. Really supports the knees. So instead of your bolster, you would use your cushion, or two cushions, or a bedroom pillow, whatever you have. And we're just gonna put it here, just get under the knees. Cushions do the same thing. Feet together again, push the bum back, make a bit of space, and sit tall. When we look down, we can see our feet together, heels together, legs. This will help anybody who's got tight hamstrings, which is really good. It's really going to help you open your lower back. So you're just going to sit up nice and tall, and then you're going to slowly tiptoe forward to your first edge. So we know our edges now. If you haven't done Yin Yoga before, we always work on our edges to find a nice opening of the body. So I just find this is a lovely way, just by walking the elbows down the legs like this. And then you find your first edge. So remember, we're looking, we have a graph between 1 and 10. We are looking for our first edge, could probably be about 3 or 4. And once you get to that first edge, you may need to readjust at somewhere in the body. And then you would just gently close your eyes. You would do a wee check-in. So I always like to do a wee check-in and check that your back's soft, your shoulders are relaxed, your face is relaxed, your hips are relaxed, your lower back's relaxed. And once your body is totally relaxed and your muscles are quiet, and I mean very quiet, give it a few more seconds, and then let's gently come a little further until we've found our edge, about 7. And once we find that edge where we can feel a significant stretch in the body, we would close our eyes and we would close down. And we would just melt the body into this position, concentrating on the breath, how we feel right now, and begin your beautiful journey in butterfly. Now remember, you will stay in this position till I invite you to leave it. If there's any pain, you would exit the pose. If there's no pain, you would remain. Please relax and gently, with loving care, begin your journey. Eyes are closed, body's relaxed, and you're gently easing and releasing. Ease and release. Silently, with stillness, ease into butterfly pose. I'll keep an eye on the time. I would like you to keep an eye on your breath. So butterfly pose is a beautiful way to stretch your lower back. You maybe feel a little stretch in your hamstrings. And you will feel your adductor muscles being stretched and your groin. This pose is really good for your kidneys and your prostate gland, and highly recommended for people suffering from urinary problems. So the main area that we are targeting, every pose I take you into, we're going to target an area. So the main area we're targeting here is the hips that we spoke about at the beginning of the class, and your lower spine, because like 90% of people in the world suffer from lower back pain, chronic. So then we look at the meridians and the organs affected. And then this pose, it's your gallbladder line, because they run up the outside of your legs. Your urinary bladder line, because it runs along your spine and your lower back. And if you're feeling a gentle tug in your groin, and the stretch is felt in your inner thighs as well, your kidney and your liver is also being stimulated. So continue to breathe into the space that you are creating. The more space you create in your body, the more room there is for energy to flow. So just let your body marinate in stillness. Remember guys, Yin Yoga is a completely different class from any other classes. Works the body in a totally different way. Yin Yoga will calm the mind, and stretch the body. Yin Yoga goes deeper to target the deep, deep connective tissues in your body, including your ligaments, bones and joints. It involves passive stretching, most of which happens on the floor. And Yin Yoga will encourage you to completely relax into every pose, softening the muscles in order to move closer to the bone. Poses are held between 3 or 5 minutes and can be quite meditative, so work with the breath. When we practice Yin Yoga, we are trying to access the deeper tissues of the body. And we're also stimulating the meridians. This will help increase circulation in your joints, improve your flexibility, help with your balance, and stretch and exercise the bone and the joint area, and will help to regulate the flow of chi or energy or prana in the body. Remember, when we are in our poses, it is really lovely to concentrate on the breath. Because when we concentrate on the breath, it helps to bring us to the mental relaxation of the mind. When our breath is steady and comfortable, we are not straining. If our breath is interrupted and forced, we're straining. So we want our breath to be comfortable and relaxed. And every time you release the breath, your body may send you a little invitation to go a little deeper, and it may not. We have about 70,000 thoughts a day, and I would love you to become the observer of your thoughts, but don't get connected to them. Thoughts are like emotions, they will come and go like clouds, come and go. So we're going to take a final breath, and we are going to surrender and exit this pose into what we call rebound pose, which we are going to do in between our poses. So let's take a lovely breath then. I'll do the first rebound with you just in case you're not sure how it's done. And when you're coming out of butterfly pose, just put your hands behind your back. So take your hips a little further and then walk the hands back nice and slow. Nice and gentle. Just release the back to the floor. And slowly, when you get down, just take the hands out. Just let your knees stay there for one more breath. And then bring the knees together. Put the knees together and put your feet to the two corners of the mat. Close your eyes and then take your two feet to the two corners and let's enjoy rebound. Now the reason we do rebound pose in between our poses is to give our body time to do its to-do list. So your body's a lot to do in rebound pose because you've been detoxing. So it wants to eliminate the toxins out of the body, which is why we become dehydrated in Yin Yoga. It wants to rebalance, reboot. Think about a flat battery. So when you're in rebound, your batteries are being recharged. Your body's doing a wonderful thing here. We're just going to put the flat of the feet back on the floor. We're going to bring the knees to the chest. You can cross your feet at the ankles if you would like to. And draw three or four circles in each direction. And this will help with the maintenance of the spine. And the lower back. Mainly the lower back. Knees to the chest. Unhook if you hooked, feet to the floor, and then we just roll again onto the right hand side. Just roll and gently come up under your seated position. And what we're going to do when we come up, we're going to go into half or full shoelace. Okay. So we're just going to sit with the two legs out in front. And we'll come into half or full shoelace. By the way, you see a lot of skin on my mat. I'm doing a foot where all the skin comes off your feet. It's like removes all the skin from your feet. So you're just going to sit up nice and tall. And let's start with the left leg. Okay, so you're going to bring the left leg in towards your chest. And what you're going to do, you're giving it a wee hug first. We just want to hug it in first. So to use the two arms. And then you're just going to lift it off the mat. You can just lift it with your elbow and just cross it over. You've done this loads of times. You will be used to it. So when you get it over, you know that the feet, the toes should be facing me. So your feet isn't turned to the side or anything. The toes are facing me. And then you're going to wrap your arm around it. Okay, so that's the left leg and the left arm. Yep. And then you're going to take the opposite arm out. And then you're going to wrap the opposite arm around it. So remember, you changed arms. You're going to put your hand up to your elbow and you're going to turn round. And you're going to offer your body a twist. Now, twisting's really good in this position. This twist sitting like this is really good in Yin Yoga because it's really good for the back, for the spine, for the neck. And when we twist in a pose, it's like wringing out a dirty dishcloth. So we're getting rid of all the in between the liver, the kidneys, the heart, the liver, and the spleen. It's a lovely way of working your spine. It's really good for your digestive system too. It's really good for the neck. So we're just going to pause here for about two more breaths. Looking over that shoulder without forcing. And then we're just going to slowly come round. So if you know shoelace well and you also already know your ability, half shoelace is leg over, nearly knee on top of knee, and gently coming forward. So that would be your half shoelace. If you're happy to stay in half shoelace, I would like you to stay here at your first edge and then dropping down into your second edge. If you would like to go a little deeper, you would turn to the foot. You would take the back leg in behind you. And then you would help your body get into the right position. Which is sort of knee on top of the knee again. But when you look down, the feet are coming out nearly in line. And both buttocks would be on the mat. Now sometimes you can do full shoelace, but one hip could be off the mat slightly. And all you would do there is put either a blanket under it or a cushion so that you feel even on the mat. So you want to feel even on the mat. And remember, if you're in half shoelace, you're still there. You're just pausing and breathing. If you've decided to go into full, you will just slide forward into full shoelace. And you'll just pause here. And again, once you have got your first edge, you pause, you breathe, you relax the face, the neck, the shoulders, you make sure there's no tension in the body, and then you would gently come to your second edge. Please, please, if you feel any pain at all, gently ease out of the pose. When you're in a yin pose, You hold the pose without sort of moving or fidgeting. And there's only two reasons you would move in a yin pose. One is to come out of it, because you've gone too far. And the other one is to go deeper, because your body has released. So close your eyes for me. Settle into the pose. Watch the breath. Let's go on our second journey. Okay, let's just breathe into this space that we are creating again. Great hip opener and decompresses the lower spine when folding forward. Guys, listen to the breath. Check in on the breath. Check in on you. Joints affected. The main joints are the hips and the lower spine. The meridians and organs affected is your liver, your kidneys, your gallbladder. And if you're folding forward, the urinary bladder lines will be stimulated and your stomach will be compressed. So let's enjoy our time in shoeless pose. Just continue to breathe in this pose, in shoeless. Letting go and relaxing the mind. Remember, thoughts may pop into the head. I want you to become an observer of your thoughts and continue to breathe. Just continue to breathe. Letting go. Let your body relax. Every time you breathe out, maybe your body will relax just a little bit more. Just breathe. Going to stay here for about another 60 seconds. Just let your body be still and relax. Let your hips melt, let your shoulders, your neck, your face relax. Take a beautiful breath and let's exit this pose. So whether you're in half or full shoelace, just come up. If you're in full shoelace, just relax the legs out. If you're in half shoelace, just relax the legs out. Put your hands behind your back and slowly ease your body down to rebound pose. Take the hands out, keep the legs out in line with the mat, close your eyes and just be. Notice the energy maybe moving into the feet, into the fingers, into the shoulders. Sometimes when we come out of a yoga pose, it can release maybe an emotion. And just feel our bodies relax, especially when we use the power of the breath and the mind. Please just bend your legs again. Roll to the side. Come back up onto your hips. Take your legs back out again. And then take your right knee in. So just take the right leg in this time. You sit up nice and tall. You cross the right leg over the left. Right hand around up. We did with the other side and we put the opposite arm out. So we can wrap the whole way around. Turn the body round. Beautiful twist to the other side. And I go over the opposite shoulder. And we're just sitting up nice and tall. Twisting and breathing. Lengthening up through the spine. And just looking over the shoulder. Pause and breathe. Pause and breathe. Every time you breathe out, you may notice the body go a little further. You may be not. Let's turn. Breathe. Listen. Every time you breathe out, just gently, slowly. Pause for a few more breaths. Oh, working into the liver, the kidneys, the heart, the spleen, the large and small intestines, all them upper body meridians are based in it. And then slowly come back right. And we can either, if we know our bodies already, and we know that we are gently coming down into full shoelace. We can, or sorry, half, we come into half. And again, if you would love to come into full shoelace, remember, no two sides of your body is the same. You come round to the foot, take the leg back, get the two hips down, shimmy, 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 hips down. Use your hands to move the feet about. One knee nearly on top of one knee. And that could be enough for you. That could be you happy just sitting here, just balancing the two sit bones on the mat and breathing. A nice mindfulness breath, just sitting breathing. Just taking the time out just to work on you. This is your time. Self-care. If you want to come forward, you gently can come forward. So we're going to have a wee visitor here in a moment. My beautiful flow is coming in to join me in a way again. And then just gently lower down. I just want you to close your eyes. And I just want you to pause here. With your eyes closed, and I want you to concentrate on your breath. Just concentrate on your breath. Concentrate on the breath. Let your body relax. So we know in this pose, the meridians and the organs affected as the liver, kidney, gallbladder, and a folding forward, the urinary bladder and your tummy. So remember what meridians are. Meridians are the English translation of the Chinese word for the channels that will conduct energy throughout your body. And these conducts form a network. Now, if the network is disrupted, if blockages occur, your body will not perform properly. It will not function properly either. So chi energy, prana, for another word, is not getting to flow as required. Your organs will then not perform their function. And this is when imbalances arise. But when the meridians are clear and open, it gives energy space to flow freer. And this helps your body heal, keeps your body well, keeps your body free from disease. So let's just take some more breaths. We use the breath as a tool in our yin yoga poses. The tool that helps our body open and makes space for energy to flow. So the breath has a very important function in yin yoga. It helps the body to relax. Just pause and breathe, pause and breathe. Just let your body relax. So if you remember, water requires a bank before it can become a river. Prana also requires a path along which to travel. These pathways are nadis, which means little rivers. So if we want to make space in the body so that our rivers can flow, I'm going to stay here for a few more breaths, just surrendering into the pose. Just let your body surrender into the pose gently as you release. Just let your body relax into the pose. Nice and relaxing, nice and relaxing. Okay, so guys, no matter where you landed, I would love you to release out of it. Nice and slow. Just take your legs out. For full or half shoelace. And let's take the body back down into rebound. Whatever way is best for you, just take your body back down into rebound. And just pause there. Pause and rebound. Just take your arms out to the side. Let your feet come to the two corners. And be still. Just let the body have this wee bit of time just to let that energy recirculate around the body. Listen to the breath, relax the shoulders. Just let your body be still. And then just gently put your two feet to the two corners of the mat for me. And just take your legs to the left. We're doing our little window wiper to the left, take the arms out. Look over your right shoulder if your back allows it, and then take your legs to the right and just gently look over your left shoulder and come back to the center. Now we're just going to bring the two feet together, keep the arms out to the side, and we're just going to finish with a little twist. So we're going to keep our shoulders on the mat, we're going to keep the legs together, and I'd just like you to lift your hips gently, slide them more to the left, and drop your knees to the right, if that's accessible for you. Now when you drop your knees to the right, if you can't get the knees down, please don't force them. Put a wee pillow under the knees here. Put a wee bit of support under the knees. If you find your knees are not coming to the floor, use a bit of support and put, you know, put your knees on top. As long as I want, when your knees are to the right, you would want your left shoulder blade to stay on the mat. If you have sciatica, you bring the knees higher, okay? If you've lower back pain, you can take the legs slightly lower. Arms are right in the cross position, and you would be looking over your left arm for me. And just breathe. And I just want you to close your eyes. Settle your shoulders down into the mat. And just be still. So I just want you to stay here for another 2 minutes. So I'm going to stay here for another 2 minutes. Just letting your body relax into your reclining twist. So twisting at the end of the practice will help to restore equilibrium in the nervous system and release tension in the spine. And again, if you bring your knee higher, or bring your knees higher, you can release sciatica. Also massages your stomach organs and can cure gastritis. So remember, bringing your knees higher or lower will affect where in the spine the stretch is felt. So if the knees are higher, this moves the twist to the upper back. Lowering the knees moves the twist more to the lumbar sacrum. The arm that's on the floor to the left, I would love you to take it now over your head. So just take the hand back over your head and keep it on the floor for the last minute. So twisting the spine will stimulate the urinary bladder line, and because now that one hand is overhead, several meridians in the arm are stimulated: the heart, the lungs, the small and large intestines. Twisting compresses the stomach and massages your internal organs, and twisting through the rib cage stimulates the gallbladder meridians and helps the liver, spleen. And your pancreas nurtures the shoulder joint and the upper spine, as well as all the tissues in your upper chest, breast and shoulder. So I am gently going to invite you to bring the arm that was overhead back down. Gently bring your knees back to the center. Walk them in. Bring your spine and long back in along with your hips. Lift your hips, set it gently to the right this time, and drop your knees to the left. You can bring them up a wee bit higher. Once you get them over, use your cushion if you cannot get them down to the floor. You can even put your top hand on top if you want a wee bit of stimulation there with your hand on top. And you can put your right hand over the head, or you can keep it out for the first minute. Feel it in a different stretch, and then put it over your head for the second minute. Okay, so let's put it out straight first. If you want to look round over the arm, remember you can, depends on how your neck is. Just close your eyes, soften your face, soften your shoulders, soften your lips, and just breathe. And just be still. And just marinate in the stillness of this pose. Just beautiful stillness. Stillness in the body, stillness in the mind. Uses less energy. Keeps the prana within. Keeps the body balanced. An excellent final pose of the practice because it removes kinks and knots. So just relax and do your final pose. And now maybe move that hand up over the head for the last minute and just be. Let not a person revive the past or in the future build his hopes. For the past has been left behind and the future has not been reached. Instead, with insight, let him see each presently arisen state. Just take a few more breaths in this position. And then very, very gently, the outstretched, the arm behind the head would come out to the side. Both arms would be on the floor, eyes would come to the ceiling. And gently bring your knees back to the center. Just give them a little hug. Moving three times in one direction, three times in the other direction. Just hold your knees to your chest and gently come back into your rebound pose, which is your final pose, which is also called Savasana. And in Savasana, you would really, really benefit from a lovely wee blanket maybe around you. Even if we're not cold, sometimes a wee blanket can just make us feel more comfortable, more peace. Just to keep that lovely, peaceful state within, the calm. And let's connect back into the breath. Eyes are closed, body's relaxed. Mind is relaxed. And I just come to the toes and we relax the toes. The sole of the feet, the front of the feet, the ankles, the calves, the shins, the front of the knee, the back of the knee, the front of the thigh, the back of the thigh. The inner thighs. Our glutes. Our lower back, our middle back, upper back, shoulders, shoulder blades and arms. The back of the neck, the back of the head, the top of the head, the side of the head, the ears, the cheeks, the chin. The face. The scalp. The frown lines, the eyebrows, the eyes, the nose, the cheeks. The chin, the jawline, our lips, our mouth, our throat, collarbones, our chest, our arms, our fingers.
internal organs, our digestive system, our pelvic floor, our back, our spine. Just let that energy flow be released. Just be still. Just be still for a few more breaths. Just enjoying this time for you. This moment. There's no phone ringing. There's nowhere to go. There's nothing to do but just be still. And then very, very gently, I would love you to become aware of the space again, the room, and just bring a little bit of movement into your toes. Maybe just roll the ankles round a few times in each different direction. Fingers, wrists. And then gently bring the knees to the chest. Do them three circles again in each direction. Then when your knees are back to the center, I want you to roll on to the right and just fall into your nice be fetal position. And just be. Just pause. Noticing the stress, maybe the fear, the anxiety that you come in, or shall I come onto your mat with, is gone. It's now behind you. And in front of you right now, it's just a beautiful golden light, sunshine, new energy. New peace, clearance of the mind, joy in your heart. How is your soul? I hope your soul's at rest now. As you very, very gently come back into your seated position with me. Just sit nice and tall again, just come back in. One leg in front of the other, whatever's comfortable for you. You sit up, hands on the knees. And just take a few breaths. Keep the eyes closed. And just notice how you feel. How many times do you check in with yourself? Ask yourself, how am I doing today? And keep your hands on your knees and just gently ease back. And then just gently ease forward and lift your chest up. And just smile. And then just sit nice and tall. We're just going to bring the hands to the heart. We're going to think of something that makes, just fills our heart with joy and gratitude. Our health. For one. And we're just going to take the hands above the head. Just take a much slow, big, deep breath and just take the hands above the head. Just pause here for a breath. And just bring the hands back down to the heart. Thank you very, very much. We say Namaste. And as we come forward into Namaste, with our hearts full of gratitude, let's just think of someone maybe who could do with some healing.
to just send them some healing. Time. Just come up. Okay, thank you very, very much, guys. I miss everybody so much that would come to the in class with me, and I really, really look forward for us all being together soon, and I really hope it's not too long. So thank you very, very much, and I will see us all again soon. Thank you. Bye.